day. Okay, let's go.
Welcome back to my channel. If you're new to this channel, hi, my name is Maba and I'm here to chit chat with you. So welcome back to day three of Vlogmas. I am actually loving this. It's quite interesting and it's honestly keeping me on my feet in terms of creativity, because I always have these ideas, but then now at least I'm going to put them into action, you know what I mean? Yeah, okay, so stick around and enjoy this video. I hope you enjoy it. If you don't, then better luck next time. So yeah, I've already done my makeup, so obviously the video is not about me doing my makeup, and you can see from the title of the video I'm just going to be showing you how I moisturize my hair or just oil my hair. One of the reasons I wanted to make this video is because sometimes people forget that you need to still keep your hair clean even though you have braids. You know, you can still wash your hair even when you have braids. Don't wait for 6 weeks plus for you to now decide to wash your hair and stuff like that, especially for some of us who like to exercise. Some of us who like to exercise, the hair does get a little bit sweaty, and also dust and dirt accumulates in the braids. So washing your braids is actually okay. It doesn't damage the braids, it doesn't make them look older. I mean, look at this. My hair actually even looks cleaner, which is a good thing. And also, you just want to smell nice, you don't want to have smelly hair. So it's important to wash your hair even though it's in braids. Shop. Let's begin. So firstly, I shampooed my hair and right now it's still sort of dripping. I towel dried it, but it's not completely dry. But anyways, that's not the point. So today I actually wanted to even give a review on a certain shampoo and conditioner that I used for the first time. So I shampooed my hair with this. So this is the Protein Feed shampoo. And to be honest, it felt really nice on my scalp. Of course, I can't give a complete review on how it affects the texture of my hair because it's in the braids, but it didn't feel coarse or rough when I used the shampoo, so I think it's a good shampoo. And then I use the same brand of the conditioner. So this one's the Protein Feed conditioner and it also felt nice, and these products actually smell quite nice. So yeah, I'm not so sure where you can get these products because I just got these from my friend Maziko. So I don't know where she bought them. So clumsy. So I don't know where she bought them, but I'm pretty sure they're quite affordable, I hope. So if you know where to get these products, please comment down below, because I would like to just sort of view the other products that they have. Anyways, yeah. Actually, I can just Google that. Yeah. Okay, so after I shampooed and conditioned my hair, now I'm going to show you guys what I do after. I'm going to add leave-in conditioner. I still have some left in this. If you watch that video that I made where I was actually doing these braids, I said I was going to get a new one, but I didn't. So I'm just going to try and squeeze out as much as I can and then just keep the conditioner in my hair. So step one, leave-in conditioner. Give yourself a little massage. Ah, that feels so nice. Ooh, okay. After that's done, I'm now going to go in with the oils. So the oils that I'm using today are this one, MPL. This is the plug, guys. This is the plug. forget all those expensive products. This one, amazing. So this one is just the original one. Sometimes it comes in coconut flavored, and I forgot the others, but I'm just going to use the original one. So this one is one of the oils that I'm going to use. The other oil that I'm going to use is this tiny thing from Clix, and it's castor oil. Castor oil, as we know, is a key product when you want to just keep your hair in check, because it helps with thickness and strength of the hair. And then the last one that I'm going to use is Jamaican black castor oil. This is also the plug, because it also does the same thing as this little baby right here. So I'm going to use both castor oils and MPL oil just to oil my hair. I decided to use oils because I didn't want something heavy on my hair, because I also have this black castor oil hair food, but I'm not going to use this right now. I am actually just going to use the lid so I can mix the different oils. Of course, it doesn't smell the best. It literally smells like Vicks. It smells like Vicks. But the feeling after you put this on your scalp is so refreshing. It's got this minty feeling to it. Okay, so that's my MPL. And then let's add the... I should put this on my lap. Okay, so I have my oil in this little thing. I don't know if you can see it, but I don't want it to tip over. But yeah, so I have my oil. Now I'm going to start adding it to my hair. One thing that I like to do is actually just section the hair, so it's easier to keep track of the lines that you've applied the product and the ones that you haven't. So what I do is bring everything to the front, right? And then actually I can just tie one side. I'm just going to tie this side. Guys, this year has gone by so fast, hey? But it was quite a hectic year. This year has been really, really difficult. Okay, so I'm going to tie that side, and then I'm going to bring these braids to the front. And then what I'm going to do is every time I put the oil, I take the braids to the back. So let us begin. Just dip the finger and then oil. If you want, you can actually massage the oil as you go, but I like to just apply it to the scalp first, section by section. And then I just like to run my fingers through it, like that. Now that that's done, with the leftover oil, I'm just going to go around on the sides, basically my edges, because woo, child, your edges need to be oiled and moisturized and all that good stuff so they can be strong and healthy. After that, now you just want to go in and massage that oil, because the oil needs to go through those pores. It needs to reach the hair follicles, so you must massage your hair, like literally just go in there, massage it for a few minutes or seconds if you're lazy. Honestly, I don't know if I'm lazy, but I'm probably just gonna do it for a few seconds. And we're done. So that's how I keep my hair clean and moisturized and feeling fresh and looking good. So try it out and tell me what you think, because honestly, guys, we need to normalize washing braids. That's it for me to you for today, and I'll see you tomorrow in my next video. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to share, and also turn the notification bell so you know every single time that I upload a video, especially during this Vlogmas period. So that's it from me, your Nubian queen, natural hair goddess, natural hair advocate. Okay, that's a wrap. Bye.